Hello students, today we are going to discuss about elements of building construction chapter. This chapter is common for both the subjects, so that is ME145 and ME147. And if you have seen the topics what you have already discussed in this chapter, which are types of building, design loads, building components, and the topic which is principles of planning is what we are going to discuss today. When you are talking about principles of planning, after the selection of a suitable location for the building, the next step of a building construction is the planning stage. Say for example, if you construct a building with a proper planning and all the arrangement of different components of the building is made in a systematic manner, so the total building will become a homogeneous body that will help that will create a comprehensive look, and it meets the functional purposes of all the components of that building. The residential buildings needs to be planned according to the need of the occupant and also according to the availability of funds. So the planning should be functional planning. Actually, that should meet with the requirement of different buildings and should not follow any traditional style. So when you are talking about the construction of a residential building, which is considered to be the largest single investment one is going to do in their entire lifetime, these things are very essential to plan properly to construct a proper residential building. So major components or the considerations we have to take into account while thinking for a planning of residential building, that the pupils who are going to stay there and the requirements of them. For example, some of the people may have an interest to they may have a specific requirement for their different components of a building. Like someone may like to have a bigger bedrooms, or someone may like to have a bigger kitchen, and someone may like to have a kitchen completely detached from the drawing room and dining area. So that depends on the people, so that needs to be taken into consideration. Second point we should take into consideration is the climate of that region, whether it is a whether the region is a hot environment or the region is a cold environment or it is a rainy environment. So based on that, we will have to consider the planning and the arrangement of building, different components of building like windows, doors, openings, entrance or the front side, dining room, bedroom, kitchen. These things needs to be arranged. Building bylaws of that particular region should be taken into consideration, and the availability of materials and different methods also needs to be considered while going for a construction. So in this background, if we are talking about the parameters we are supposed to consider, that we call it as the principles of building planning, and that includes 11 main aspects or 11 main points, which are aspect, prospect, privacy, furniture requirement, roominess, grouping, circulation, sanitation, flexibility, elegance, economy. Okay, so these are the 11 main general principles we have to follow while considering the building planning. So each of these things individually we'll be discussing there here in this chapter, but while planning the building, we may have to do little bit of adjustments, and we have to evaluate that which aspects we can compromise and which points we have to stick with. It all depends on the people who are going to construct that building. Let us go to the first one, that it is the aspect. So aspect is a parameter which actually says about that the direction. So which kind of rooms of building should be located as per their function, keeping in view of the direction of sun and wind. For example, some of the components of a building may not need early morning sunlight, or in other part, some of the other building components will like to have an early morning sunlight, for example, if you are talking about kitchen. So kitchen is possibly to be provided in the eastern portion of the building or the eastern direction of the building. So that will give an early morning sunlight to the building, and that will act as a disinfectant to the building. The sunlight, natural effect of the sunlight, will give do the work, and early morning sunlight is better for the kitchen area, whereas the dining area, which is better to be provided in the southern direction, and the drawing rooms are better depending on the availability of the direction. It is south, southeast or northeast positions are good. Bedrooms are usually at southwest, west or southeast directions, and study rooms are north or northwest direction. Store room, which can be provided in the northern direction because it doesn't need any light, and cool condition can be good for the storage of things, and bath and WC wash and closets can be provided in north or northeast portion of the building. So aspects can be achieved by proper planning a building and arranging doors and windows suitably. This is the aspect. So this is a general arrangement of the building where we can see the location of different components of the building, and some of the things are not as per the suggestions, and in areas where we are having limitations. So as I earlier said, that some of the things we'll have to compromise while doing the general planning of a building. So that is aspect. Now if you go to the second parameter, that is the prospect. Prospect gives how a building will look if it is viewed from outside, and the placement of opening in front walls to give aesthetic appearance, and on one other hand should conceal undesirable views. So while we are providing the doors, windows and all on the front side of the building, so how beautifully this can be viewed from outside of the building, and at the same time, while providing a beautiful view of the building, these things should be given, the windows and the doors, the opening should be given in such a way that it should conceal the unwanted things, or it should be provided in the areas where it provides a good view. For example, if you have a river or a lake in one side of the building, so that can be and that side can be provided with a window or a door, so that will be a good view for the people who are residing in the building. Whereas if in one side of the building, if it is having a waste dump or something where it is an undesirable view for the people who are going to stay inside the building, so that area should not be given any opening. So that is what the prospect of the building. So after going through the proper planning, proper alignment of, and the proper designated places is allotted for the windows and doors, so it will be creating a good environment for the people who are going to stay there. Privacy is the other important thing, that is the another third principle of planning, that the building should have two different kind of privacy. What is the building as a whole, that the view from outside the building should be limited, or the view when we are sitting inside the room. So for example, if you are sitting inside the room in the dining or in the drawing room, so what are the areas exposed to the person who is sitting there? So that is actually controlled by the position of doors which are providing in the rooms. For example, if this is a bedroom, and if you are providing a door or an opening in the middle of the bedroom, so that exposes more area for the people who are sitting outside this room. Or another way, if you are providing it in the corner, that corner of the room, so that it restricts the area which is exposed, and it is more practical. Whereas in the third case and in the first case, both the cases we are in the first case we are providing a door in the middle of the room, and the second case it is slightly apart from the wall. So in both these cases, the area which is backside of this door is not able to use, because this part would be will be the area which we have to keep empty to open the door. So that much area we are it is not going to be useful for us, whereas in the second case this area would be more useful. Even if this privacy is providing in the third case, but it is reducing the usable space of that particular room, so this is not considered as a very good practice. It is not considered as practicable. So that is the privacy. So for the external privacy, if we may provide some boundary walls, or we can produce tall trees in the near the boundary walls to control the privacy. Or in the case of inside the room, so the position of doors, curtains, and things can be managed so that it should get a proper privacy, the people who are living inside the room. Next one, it is the grouping. So grouping means that what all components of the building can be grouped together. For example, if you're taking the kitchen and the dining area, so that can be grouped together. Or it is not at all a good idea to group kitchen and toilet bathroom. So if you are having, if you see a building which when you come out of the kitchen or when you come out of the bathroom, toilet bathroom, then we are entering into a kitchen, so that may not be a very good grouping. So likewise, the veranda can be adjacent to a drawing room, so that is a good grouping. Dining room close to kitchen, that is also a good grouping. But dining room close to or bedroom and toilet, dressing rooms grouped together, bath and wash and closet should be nearer to each other. So these are all the areas or the good groupings what we can go for. So while looking into the grouping aspects, we have to see what is the function of that different room. Based on that, the functional functional characteristics of the different components of the building should be grouped together. So it will reduce the unnecessary movements, and it can be easily controlled, and it overall affect the economical aspect of the construction of that building. Next point, it is the roominess. Roominess is the term used to refer the effect derived from the space of a room, that is the ratio of its length, width and height. So the square rooms, if you consider that economical aspects, cost is minimum but has minimum usable area. Because for example, if you are taking, this is a square room by 4 by 4 meter square room, total gives 12 meter square of area. But after leaving this passage, because when you are providing the doors in one part of this, so this much area which is going for a passage and it is not usable, so the remaining area for usable area is drastically reducing in this case. Whereas in this case, where the length and width of the room is 4.6 and the 3.5 meters, so it looks beautiful, and the usable area is also sufficient enough for the people. And it doesn't mean that increasing the length increases the usable area. For example, in this case where the length of the building is 5.3 meter and this is 3 meter, so the usable area is increasing, but it gives an effect, we call it as the tunneling effect, that it looks ugly. Like if you are entering into the room, we may feel like we are entered into a tunnel or something like that. So that doesn't seem so good for the or the roominess aspect. So this ratio of the height, length and breadth of the room is called, that is roominess. Next is the circulation. Circulation is the amount of wind which is allowed to flow through that particular room. And it should be something like, there are two different kind of circulations we can understand. One is the horizontal ventilation or the horizontal circulation, and the vertical circulation. Horizontal circulation means the wind blowing from the veranda to the passage, to the corridors, to different rooms, and then to the lobbies and the halls. So that is the horizontal ventilation. Vertical ventilation, that is at least should be 8 to 10% of the floor area should be floor area of the building is considered to be allowing a passage of wind through its different floors, like the staircases or other things. So that is the circulation. So in circulation point of view, there are four different conditions provided here, that the position of the rooms are opposite each other. It gives a very good aspect for the circulation, that it is the best case. But in this case, space divides divided. So this even after giving it a good circulation, but the space which is leaving here, which is divided by this passage, and this is not a very useful condition. This is two doors which are provided in the same direction. It's practically the ventilation may be good, but the practicability is very poor, because this kind of rooms we may not be considering. And in this case, the doors are given in opposite sides, so it gives a very poor condition, because the usable area is very less and the ventilation also may not be very proper in this case. So out of these four cases, the best case is the doors are provided in the corner and opposite sides of the room. Now the next is the elegance. Says that how beautifully the building can be seen in its elevation. Elevation is the view of the building from its front side. So by keeping different elevations or providing a different ventilations or projections, we can make the building or beautiful. So it is basically the architectural effect produced by the elevation. So the produced by elevation, which depends upon the proportion of width, height and position of doors and windows, as also the choice of material. So by providing different varieties of materials, we can improve the elegance of that building. The visualization of elevation should always kept in mind while preparing the plan. So the engineer who is going to design these things should always keep these things in mind, that how my building will look like. If all internal things and everything is perfectly arranged, and the aspect and prospect and everything are managed, but if the building is not seen good from outside, it actually affects the total appearance of that building. So that is not a good idea. So these things needs to be taken into consideration. Flexibility of a building, that means some part of the rooms can be kept in such a way that at case of emergency or in case of occasional needs, we can convert that room for any other purpose. For example, a part of the drawing room can be used as a guest bedroom. So as you know that in every residential buildings, there should be very limited number of occasions where we may have a number of guests coming into our house. So we can keep things in mind that when these guests are coming, we should provide some area for them to sleep. So what areas can be converted to a sleeping area? So that kind of flexibility can be given. For example, in some of the houses, there may be a small open space, or there may be a small open sitting area providing on the ground floor or on the first floor of the of a tenement. So that can be easily converted to a sleeping area for in case of any situations where we are having some guest at home. So that kind of things we consider, that is called flexibility. Next it is the sanitation. Sanitation is basically the provision of different agents of sanitation, like light, ventilation and thermal comfort. So light is a very good illumination, and it also provides a hygiene condition. And the passage of wind, it actually act as a agent which removing the bad air, and provides good healthy environment for the people who are living inside. So lighting should be kept into mind while doing the planning. The ventilation, that what are the areas where wind can be blown through and where it can go out. So that thing should be considered. For example, if we are going to consider a wind which is coming through a ventilation of a toilet bathroom, and if that wind is going or flowing going to a kitchen or a dining area, that is really not a hygienic condition for living. So that kind of thing should be avoided. So the flow of wind should be managed in such a way that the bad air or the bad smell from the room should be carried away from the building, and fresh air should be given to the area. So there are every building, there are some areas where we expect, for example, in kitchen when you are cooking, there are number of different smells or the oils which are going to be in the kitchen area. So that should be taken out from that kitchen area, and it should not be, as far as possible we should try that all that kitchen cooking smells and the steams and all that things should not flow into the drawing room or in the bedroom. Rather, it should be flowing away from the building, so that ultimately keep the cleanliness of the building, and different sanitary units can be provided so that wash basins and cleaning areas can be provided, so the room should be hygiene enough. So the second last point, it is the economy and practical considerations. So the economic aspects, it is obviously depending upon the person who is going to construct that building. But as an engineer who is planning the building, should be keeping it in mind that proper planning and utility of space being maximized. So we should not waste the construction. So whatever area what we are constructing and the floor space available should be properly used. So in some cases when you are looking into other aspects, so some of these things may not be possible, but it has to be tried or level best or for the engineer that we should use the entire area for useful purpose. Furniture requirements, as we have to keep it in mind that what are the requirements of furnitures which is supposed to be used in each and every component of the building, and we should provide sufficient space allotted for that furnitures, and we should keep in mind after putting this furnitures that whether the space is available for, or the clearance is available for the movement or for the circulation of wind. So that things should be keeping in mind. So the dimensions of the drawing rooms or the bedroom should be considered in such a way that it has to decide that what is the useful space after the after providing all these furniture requirements. So